All right, I got something to show you. Ready? Ready? Are you ready for this? Ready? Bam! Pretty cool, huh? So in this video, I'm gonna be showing you how to add some images to your videos. Adding images to a video can be used for a number of different use cases. Maybe you wanna add your logo into the corner of your video. Maybe you're doing a reading hater comments type of video and you need to display the comments on your video as well while you read them. Maybe you got a nice big brain and you gotta show some statistics with all the topics you're talking about. In this video, we're gonna be using our product Type Studio to do all of that and show you how to do all of that, all within a free online video editor. So let's go ahead and hop onto a computer so I can show you how that works and we can get you on your way. So first things first, what you're gonna do is you're gonna go to our website, typestudio.co. You're gonna go up to the top right, you're gonna sign up and sign in for free. All right, so once you finish up signing up and signing in, it's gonna bring you to our dashboard. And here on the dashboard is where you can upload and house all of your videos and projects. So for this instance, we're gonna be creating a new project so I can show you how it all works from scratch. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna click new project, and then we're gonna find a video that we want to edit. So I'm gonna do the social media post with the logo in the top left. I'm gonna show you how to do that first. So find your video, grab it, drag it, and drop it in, and let it upload and transcribe. So here's our video. In order to add an image to this video, we're going to click on a word and click this little image icon. Once you do that, it'll bring up an upload screen. So find that logo that you wanna drag and drop in, found our type logo, I'm gonna drag it and drop it in, let it upload into the video project, and bam, look at that. Now that it's in here, I have the ability to manipulate it, maybe drag it and make it smaller and put it up in the top right-hand corner, just like that. And as you can see, it also snaps to the sides of the project as well as the center lines and center axes. So if you want to throw it up in the exact right-hand corner or dead center, you can do that too. But I'm gonna give it a little bit of room, a little bit of breathing room. That's what I like to do. So now if I hit play, you'll see something that happens.
What's going on, everybody?
Oh, it's Alex. It goes away. Well, in order to change that, you see this little column here? We have to drag this column to the end of the video to show longevity. It indicates how long that image will last throughout the video. So it starts at this image right here, this little icon, and then ends at the column. So if I want this logo to be there the entire video, I'm gonna make sure that this icon is all the way at the beginning, and then this column is all the way at the end. So if we hit play.
What's going on, everybody? It's Alex with Type Studio, and I'm just making...
The logo will stay there the entire time. Now, once done with this, all you have to do is hit the export button, and then you'll be able to download it on our sharing page. So let me show you how to do that before we go ahead and jump into any of the other videos that I'll show you how to do today. So hit export. And once your video is done exporting, you can download it here on the sharing page. In order to do so, you just click the download button, and it'll download right onto your computer. All right, so let's go back so I can show you how to make the comment video where you're commenting on other comments and you can show them right here, just pop up the comments, you know? So for this one, we're gonna start another project. I'm gonna find that video, I'm gonna drag it and drop it in and let it upload and transcribe yet again. So once uploaded, let's watch through the video real quick so we can see where we wanna add this comment.
Hey, what's up, everybody? We're gonna be going through some of my favorite comments that we've gotten on these videos. The number one comment that we have, let me read it real quick. It says, "Hey, I left a mean comment on here about 6 years ago, and I want to apologize." That's so nice. It's such a.
All right, cool. So I want to put it here, and it says, bam. And I'm going to add the image here. I'm going to go find the image, back to images, drag it and drop it in, and uploading it into the picture. And there it is. Look at that. I'm going to drag it until the end of where it says, or where I'm done talking about it. So let's check this out. I'm gonna drag it, oop, make it a little bit bigger. And so I'm gonna snap it to the middle. So like, I don't know, I think that looks pretty good. I think that gives it like its own little area, snapping it to the center line, bring it down maybe. Nah, I think I like it down here a little bit better. Bam. All right. So let's hit play and show you how it looks.
The number one comment that we have, let me read it real quick. It says, "Hey, I left a mean comment on here about 6 years ago, and I want to apologize." That's so nice. It's such a heartfelt thing, meaning that we really changed our game and maybe we changed some minds in the process. Maybe this person came.
All right, perfect. Yeah, I like that a lot. So in order to just throw an image on there and talk about some comments and have that playful reading comments type of video, you can do that all here in Type by adding the image to your video. And maybe also if you wanna make it a little more accessible and you wanna kinda just allow people to read everything and all the comments and whatnot, maybe you can bring it up a little bit and then add some subtitles as well. That's always a good option. Just static, boom. Hey everybody.
Hey, what's up everybody? We're gonna be going through some of my favorite comments that—
There we go, see? Just easy peasy like that, couple buttons. You click the subtitles, you choose whether or not you want static or dynamic, and then there you have it. You can even change the colors of it, you can change the font, you can change all that stuff. Oh my God. And then once again, when you're done, go up to the top right and hit export so you can download that video and upload it wherever you'd like. All right, last but not least, I feel like we should just do it anyways, is show you something for the chart video, something like that. So let me find the video that I want to do, drag it, drop it in, and let it upload and transcribe as it does yet again. All right, so for this one, we're gonna watch through. I try to be a little funny with it. I try to make a joke, and I'll show you how to use some images to make a little bit of a joke, a little funny haha, you know? So let's watch this through real quick, and I'll figure out where I want to throw these images.
All right, everybody, so quick tip today on our science tip of the day. We're gonna be looking at what temperature does water freeze at? Good question, Alex. Such a good question. Not a lot of people know. Well, with this chart over here, we'll figure out when cold gets so cold that it turns frozen.
Now you might not get the joke, but let me do a little movie magic here, and I'll let you in on a little bit of the joke. So let me throw this chart here. I have an image of a chart right here. Let's go back to images and chart. If you were looking at my files, maybe you'll see what the joke is, but let's make it so that it comes in when I say chart, because I feel like that works better.
Well, with this chart over here, we'll figure out—
maybe I want to make it a little bit bigger so that it looks like it's actually sitting on my hand.
Well, with this chart over here, we'll figure out when cold gets so cold that it turns frozen.
All right, funny haha joke time. And let's add another image. Find this guy. Upload it in. And there it is. There's the funny joke. Here's the funny joke. Now let's watch this masterpiece.
Not a lot of people know. Well, with this chart over here, we'll figure out when cold gets so cold that it turns frozen. Thank you very much.
There you go. You can make little jokes now if you're quippy. Oh my God, what am I doing? All right, so yet again, once you're done and your masterpiece is complete, and maybe you threw some subtitles on there by clicking subtitles and static and then going through, and there you go. Subtitles are on. And maybe you wanna add some emphasis that it's frozen, and I'm just gonna add another text by clicking this and then adding the little T, and the text box comes up and typing, get it, frozen. And then changing it to white. Getting rid of the background, put this there, I'm gonna put this there. So now the joke is
that it turns frozen. Thank you very much.
I'm so funny, I know. All right, now once your funniness is at its peak, you're gonna go and click export and then download the video on the sharing page, like you did with the first video, so. And that's it. That's how you add images to your video with Type Studio. Free, easy, all online, and hassle-less. No hassle. That's what I meant. Thank you for watching. I hope you learned a little bit. Hope my dumb jokes made you giggle a little bit, or at least entertained you enough to stay this long in the video. I'd like to ask you to follow us on all our social medias. They're down in the description below, also floating underneath my head. Hit that subscribe button, hit that like button if you enjoyed. We post videos very frequently on this channel, and we're doing a lot of cool things with a lot of different features. So we wouldn't want you to miss out on that. So make sure you subscribe and like and comment and all those things to keep up with everything Type Studio. So thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed once again, and I will see you. Bye.